Run this shit back.
Touch my hair. When it's the feelings I wear.
Hey guys, it's Yasmin. Welcome back to my channel. And yeah, we're in a new location right now because today we're going to be doing a chit-chat while I eat some kimchi ramen. So I got some today. Yeah, it's like, looks like this. Yeah, I know my head's cut off right now, but it's whatever. Whatever. I'm just gonna, you know, put this packet in there. I've never had kimchi ramen before, so if I don't like it, that's gonna be a fucking shame. Spent $1.99 on this. What is it? Freaking 7-Eleven got mad shit. Like, they got mad ramen and stuff. So I'm about to mix the sauce in. I left a little bit of juice in it. But yeah. And there's actually like freaking pieces of like, I guess the cabbage was freeze-dried or whatever. And like the vegetable packet. And like, it smells good. Yeah, it smells good. It's hot. So y'all are not gonna see it, but today we're gonna be talking about, I've never talked about this like on camera or something, but it's good. Like, I don't really talk about this a lot. Like, I don't talk about it with my close friends because it's mad fucking weird. So we're gonna talk about a murder mystery. And I might start doing this, like, you know, eating, talking about stuff like once a month or something, you know. Ooh, that's hot. Not like spicy, y'all, but hot. So back in like 2005, this happened right down, smack dab across the street from me. A murder took place. So the people we're gonna mention, there's gonna be a father and a son, both living in the same house. We're gonna call the dad Robert, because you know he's a grown man. So it got a little bit kicked to it, but it's okay. So, and we're gonna call this son John, whatever. Yeah, so this directly happened across the street from me. And I was about probably 6 or 7. So it was around like 2006, 7, or 8. Probably 2005 or 6. Yeah, so I was probably 5 or 6. So 2007 or 2005. So there was this man, and he lived with his dad, John. John is the son, Robert's the dad. So, it's like, I never really knew. I'm going to tell it from my perspective first. I never really saw the people. Like, their house looked like, if you ever watched Monster House, back to what I was saying. So, you never really saw them outside the house. Never really saw the dad. So, the house looked like the Monster House house. Like, the house looked scary. It was, like, dingy, wood. There was no paint. And all that. So, like, what the fuck? This is like an old ass house. And I didn't, like, when I was younger, I didn't realize that someone lived there. So, the son, John, he was on drugs. And like, his dad would constantly give him money for drugs, And you know what that turns you into? A fiend. I should have got my water. But mind you, the old man's not working, so the son's demanding his drugs. The dad can't provide. The son gets upset. This happens for a while, so the dad lets him get to a withdrawal. And like, he's like demanding drugs. And the dad's like, nah, I'm not gonna give you money for the drugs. And then it happened around a couple days before Halloween. Probably the day before Halloween. Because Halloween always ends up on like a freaking weekday. I don't know why. So it was the day before Halloween. I was coming back from a Halloween party. And all you see is police cars, the TV. So like, you know, I'm a little kid. I'm like, oh, I want to be on TV. Nah, baby. So they go, they're like, they got yellow tape around the house. I'm telling you like the backstory before I tell you the real story, because I don't know what the fuck was going on until like a couple years after. They had yellow tape around that house from October to December, like beginning of January, because they couldn't find the guy and all the evidence was in that house. And yeah, so what actually happened on that fateful day? So they were having one of their disputes. They were having one of their disputes and the dad didn't want to give him any money. And the son was already fucking high and fucking mad and crazy. So he goes and he gets into a fight with his father and he ends up dismembering his father's body. They didn't come out with any other details about him, like the process before that, but he ends up dismembering his body. The torso was left in the basement, and all his other ligaments, his head, his arms, his legs, his feet, were packed in trash bags and set all around the Boston area. There was some stuff found in Roxbury, like someone found a foot in their trash can. There was some left in Hyde Park, and then there was some left all over in Dorchester and everything. And it's really fucking crazy. So he went into hiding. Obviously, you committed a crime. He went into hiding from October. And then he ended up turning himself in around February. No one clearly knows why he turned himself in. Maybe it was guilt or something, but yeah. He turned himself in. And then he's now locked up in jail. And obviously he has no bail. He was charged for murder. And obviously he's gonna receive life because, you know, Massachusetts doesn't do the death penalty. So he's receiving life in jail. And so now he's still there. He won't get out, so he won't know I'm telling this story. So yeah, I'm almost done with my kimchi noodles anyway. But I wonder how, like, the main questions I always had, like, why your father? Out of anybody else, you kill your father for money. And so They actually redid the house. Didn't tell the buyer what happened in the house. She's my neighbor now. And she had got word on the street about it. And they fixed it up nice. Like, it's really nice. But there was a dead body in the house. Like, his energy is still there. So, my aunt.